year. Sponsor and champion defines the project. They select the MBB, black belt and team member because it is the sponsor and the champion who are providing the resource, right? And then they determine the resource requirement to orient the teams. But though they are doing, the project team will be involved, you know, to complete the documentation and other things. And then the champion and sponsor should compulsorily participate in the review meetings. That is very important, right? And then master black belt, he ensures the strategic alignment of projects. Whether projects are selected with the bottom-up approach or top-down approach, what is important? The project goal should align with the strategic goal of the company. And then master black belt will absorb and then coach the team wherever required. And green belt are generally the part-time project leaders. Black belt are full-time project leaders, right? And they lead projects, help the champion to select the team member. They plan the team meetings, lead the meetings, handle the meeting logistics, communication, and then a recommendation for the changes. And these are the roles of the yellow belt. They participate in the meeting, help with the administrative task, and meet with the project leaders. These things, right? Of course, you can use them on data collection and other things. So some of the tools which are taught at the yellow belt level, the important ones are highlighted here. Over and above, these are the tools as a green belt you need to know. We are ready to teach all these things. You do have equal interest to learn all these things to make your learning an easier one. And then over and above the tools you see yellow as well as green, some advanced tools like quality function deployment. How customer requirements are converted into appropriate specifications, appropriate technical specification, that is called quality function deployment, PPPPK, process performance indices. You all might know CPCPK, which are process capability indices. But what can actually, you know, give you a very close realistic picture is PPPPK and then CPM, PPM. Some advanced tools, MANOVA and Kappa analysis, but you don't have to worry about everything in the initial stage. Let us master these two things. And then once you realize the importance of learning the other tools, you can go for the black belt, right? This hierarchy, following the hierarchy is important. I really appreciate all your decision to go for the green belt before opting for the black belt. Many people know, think that it is just a certificate. So let me get the certificate first and they'll achieve nothing when actually, you know, in a real project mode. If really wanted to succeed in the project mode and going through the green belt program is very important before the black belt. So in defined phase, we are going to teach you in depth on these tools, CTQ3, Pareto, Project Charter, and CFOC. And then in the measure phase, we'll be teaching you gauge R&R, attribute decrement analysis, DPMO, and CPCPK. And in analyze phase, starting from simple tools like brainstorming, YY analysis, fishbone, we'll take you up to hypothesis testing. Hypothesis testing will include Z-test, T-test, proportion test, chi-square test, ANOVA, right? And all those things we are going to teach you. And then in the improve phase, solution optimization. And of course, FMEA can be part of analysis phase or part of any phase. Failure mode and effect analysis and DOE, correlation and regression will be used to the improve phase. And lean tools will also help you to generate a solution. And at the control phase, you will be learning a control plan. And in fact, our ultimate goal in DMAC project is we want to remove eliminate the unevenness. Unevenness is statistically called as variation. I produce 100 products, 100 units. I want all 100 to give the same experience to my customer, right? So reducing variation is nothing but defect reduction, right? So that is the goal of Six Sigma. And I will come to lean a little later. Okay. So what is that we learned so far? Six Sigma helps improve the profit margin. How? By reducing the defects. But how do I reduce defect? By reducing variation, right? And when I say lean Six Sigma, it is not only, you know, defect reduction, it is also and I'm improving my efficiency. That is why the lean is added. When I improve the efficiency, it will improve my cash flow, right? It will reduce both the defects as well as waste. The operational cost will go down. DFSS means design for Six Sigma. Design for Six Sigma means I develop new product. That means my focus is on, you know, creating a new avenue for new revenue, right? And it improves the revenue by developing new product. Quality is meeting customer requirement consistently. As long as your products are there in the market, it should deliver, you know, the customer's expectations. So continuous improvement is also important. Quality is function of customer, process, and the people, right? Customer requirement, you must understand. Process requirement, you must understand. People requirement, you must understand. Who are people? Not only the customer, employees are also people. Business leaders are also people. So it is the employee who are involved in managing and controlling the process. So their requirement should be understood. That is why you must organize the workplace convenient for the employees. If you make it inconvenient for your employees, they will handle the process badly. Finally, the outputs will be bad for your customer, right? And quality is a function of customer requirement, process requirement, importantly, employee requirement. Make your workplace more and more convenient to the people who are actually running the process. Operational excellence is the execution of the business strategy consistently and reliably better than your competitor. It is very important to be ahead of your competitor. Otherwise, any moment they can grab your market and then you may be kicked out of the entire, you know, story. So operational excellence should be an ongoing journey. And Lean Six Sigma as an operational excellence will improve quality, reduce cost, as well as the lead time to delivery. These are all very important. And lean tools also, I will talk probably, you know, after taking your questions. And there are several lean tools exist, like Just-in-Time and Jidoka are the two pillars of lean. One is Just-in-Time, another one is Jidoka. Two things, you know, only when it is required. You want to drink a coffee, you are going to a restaurant. If they prepare a fresh coffee and give it to you, your satisfaction will be at its best. None of us like to consume a coffee or any food variety which was prepared 2 days before, isn't it? Same way, whenever customer places an order, you produce a fresh product and then deliver, their satisfaction will be at its best, right? And that is what, that is the, you know, basis for Just-in-Time. By ensuring your business process are run only just in time, you can improve your efficiency like anything. We'll talk about it. And then Jidoka is a way of visualizing. Anything will get visualized. For example, now we are expecting all of you to be on video, though I could see only Prasad and Nirmal on video, not others on video. But what is the advantage of, you know, seeing all of you on video? You cannot be distracted from listening to me. Am I correct? If you are on video, even if somebody calls you, probably you may not pay attention. So same way, Jidoka is visualization. If a machine is not working, that should be visualized immediately up to the top level. All the problems, instead of hiding, it will come to the surface. That is the beginning of improvement. If you can't even see the problem, tell me how are you going to solve it? It's very important you use tools and mechanisms, approaches to visualize the problem. That means any problem should come to the surface very fast. And that approach is called Jidoka. These are two important pillars of lean, right? And so learning lean principles and practicing all these things will definitely make your company a number one in front of your customer, right? And these are the lean tools: 7 ways, Kaizen, 5S, value stream mapping, one piece flow, OEE, overall equipment effectiveness. And there was a small discussion during the session, and one of you was saying 10%, I was saying 18%. Why there is a contradiction? You understand if you understand OEE, which our efficiency and effectiveness are not always, you know, the way we calculate. It is completely different. So we need to learn, you know, new jargons and understand our baseline. So OEE will, it's a beautiful tool, overall equipment effectiveness, TPM, total productive maintenance, how we take care of our children in the family. Are we take care of the machineries the same way in our company? Isn't it? We will be much more careful when it comes to health, that too when it comes to our children's. Same way if you take care of your equipment, that is called total productive maintenance.
What happens when the data you want is not stored in a spreadsheet? Where can you turn?
Okay. Okay is a mistake proofing approach or human error prevention approach or any kind of error prevention approach. SMED, single minute exchange of dies. How can I quickly do the setup? I don't want to do setup activity, isn't it? I want to be productive. For example, right from morning, already we have received a comment, we have not yet started. Same way, we have not started even now. What we have been doing? We are doing the setup. We are preparing your mindset, you know? We are trying to create some curiosity to learn all the tools. This is called setup time. In order to make your machine productive, there will be some unproductive work which you cannot avoid. At the same time, we must see to that we do those work consuming very less resources. And one of the tools that can help you reduce your setup time is SMED. I do the setup very fast, so my machine is ready in few seconds. But without doing that setup, I can't run the machine. So that's a SMED. Kanban. Kanban is like, you know, a pull system. What is pull? If you ask a question, then I give an answer. You don't ask a question, then I move forward, isn't it? Similarly, I go to a coffee vending machine. I put 10 rupee coin. The vending machine gives me a coffee. When the next coffee comes, when you put another 10 rupee coin. Same way, if you create some mechanism by which your machines or your process will produce output only when there is a demand, only when there is a trigger, I would say. That is called Kanban. The trigger can be a signal, maybe a pin, or maybe a card, or maybe an operator coming and saying, no, I need an output. Somehow, no, you need to run, you need to ensure you use your resources only when there is a demand. No, because pull is always better than push. That is Kanban. 3M. What is 3M? Muda, Mura, and Muri. We already spoke about Mura. Mura is variation. Similarly, Muda. Muda means waste. Non-value adding activities are called Muda. And then Muri, the overloading. Overloading means going beyond the capacity. Going beyond the capacity is not good. Your crane can lift only 1 ton of weight. I should not use it to lift 1.5 tons. If I use it, definitely no, that will lead to failures. So all these three, when you avoid, your business no will be at its best. Muda, Mura, and then Muri. Nothing but wasteful activities should be avoided. Variation should be reduced. And then overloading should be reduced. We are looking for optimization, right? And then standard work. Whoever is doing the job, results are always same. Customer experiences are always at its best. For that, standard work procedures, SOPs, policies are important. Six Sigma tools for defect reduction. There are plenty of tools. I can't name it like Lean. Because the Lean's focus is efficiency and then certain tools are given. Six Sigma as such doesn't have its own tool. Six Sigma is an approach. Six Sigma is an amalgamation of several quality management approaches. According to Motorola, Bill Smith and Michael Harry, the Six Sigma toolkit is nothing but collection of quality control tools. 7 QC tools, 7 management tools, project management tools, problem solving tools, decision making tool. Wherever you see the tool, if you think you can use it, yes, that can be called as a Six Sigma tool. Ultimately, what is our focus? Our focus is defect free products. Our focus is world class experience to our customer. That is Six Sigma. For that, we are ready to do anything, you know, that is required. So we will learn some good number of tools to achieve the desired level of effectiveness. So ultimately, we need to use appropriate tools and methods to correct and prevent the failures, right? Corrective action and preventive action, both have to be there. If there are already problems going on, do the corrective action. If no problems, do the preventive action so that your process doesn't fail in the future. So Lean Six Sigma is a kind of corrective tool as well as preventive tool. It all depends on your understanding and then the way you use it, right? And thereby you can achieve sustainable. What is sustainable? I achieve profit today and tomorrow also I will achieve. At any moment in the future, whatever improvement I demonstrated, I will continue demonstrating it. That is called sustainable. Predictable. What is predictable? Since I have standardized everything, my process will operate and its behavior is known to me. That is predictable. If the process is, the behavior is not understood by you, if the process is not under your control, you cannot predict what can happen tomorrow. And that means you are a poor manager at your position, right? You should make your processes predictable. For that, learning statistics is important. And then you not only achieve sustainable and predictable, you achieve the desirable growth in profit. Most of the time, we simply believe that profit, doubling the profit and tripling the profit are impossible. We are completely wrong. Enormous scope is there because we think there are only 10 problems in the company, but there are hundreds and hundreds of problems in the company. But when do we come to know? Only when we equip our people properly. Otherwise, problems are hidden. Problems are hidden, beyond our visibility. And then that means whatever is the growth you want to achieve, you can achieve. So Six Sigma or Lean Six Sigma, takes you to a gold mine. How much you want, you can take it. It all depends on how much you learn, how much you equip, and how much you practice. So that's it from me.
Could you...